Hi students, 10th B1. How are you all? I am your social science teacher, Ms. Loganayagi. Last week we learned one lesson of history. This week we learn history and geography together. First we learn some maps. Okay, you have to do this maps by India River map and do this maps and keep it with you. Soon I'll create one class. Google class, you can send it in that. Okay, for this geography, first session is about topography that we learn later. This after that second session is a B map of India. After that we have lessons. Okay, in this map we are going to learn these things. Is there in your book, page number 65 in your book? Maybe if you have books, you can see. We are going to learn mountains, peaks, plateaus, plains, desert, rivers, water bodies, passes, latitudes and longitudes, direction of winds. Okay, this much we learn in this class. We learn this all in next class. Okay, for everything you have to make a map. Map of India. On outline map of India, candidates will be required to locate, mark and name the following. This is the question. Okay, so you must know, you must practice. You cannot escape. Okay, do your map, then we learn the lessons. Okay, yes. Now the first one, we learn this. Latitudes and longitudes of India. Okay, by the way, you know what is latitude, what is longitude, isn't it? Yes. If you don't know, you want to know some one more time, you go through your 9th standard lesson 2. Okay, just I taught that lesson also, it's there in the YouTube link. You can go and see also. Okay, see, this is the latitude extent. Okay, India is located in 8 degree latitude and 37 degree longitude in north. Okay, and longitude is 68 degree east, 68 degree east to 97 degree east. This is this red line. 66, it's mentioned here. 68. Can you see? It's just is blurring. This is the where I'm keeping the scale. Yes, 68 degree east to 97 east degree east. So this is the full extent of India. What I showed you, that is your longitude from there to here. Okay, the latitudes are, can you see, this is the latitude. The longitudes are 68 and of degree to down 68 degree east from here to here. That is longitude from here to 97 degree east. Same 97 degree east. This is your longitude. This is your latitude. 8 degree north to 37 degree. This is 8 to 8. This is 37 to 37. 37 to 37 degree north to 8 degree north. 37 degree north to 8 degree north. Okay, this is your longitude and latitude extension. Okay, and the next map we'll see the prime meridian. That is okay, this is the prime meridian. Can you see the red dotted line? 82.5 degrees east. Okay, yes, this is the Tropic of Cancer, 23.5 degrees north. Okay, exactly the prime meridian of India, that is standard meridian of India, and this latitude cross in the place of Allahabad. Okay, 82.5 degrees. This is our time zone. India's time, standard time zone, is in Allahabad, where it's crossing. Okay, 82.5 degrees east. This is the standard meridian of India. Mark this in your map. Okay, by outline map, and mark this degrees, and mark exactly in what color your book shows. Okay, that is one map. Next, we learn this interesting map of Indian physical features. This is the key. Okay, you must memorize this key. According to the key, you are going to mark this color. India is divided into this physical features. That is, physical features means rivers, mountains, plateaus, plains. That all we'll call landforms physical features. You remember? Yes, in your small class you have studied this. First we'll see Himalayas. We call by one more name, northern mountains. All located in northern side. So we call that northern mountains or Himalayas. Brown in color. Okay, from here to it's stretching full and goes till here. Why it's in white color? This is not our country. This is Nepal, our neighboring country. So we cannot mark this in brown color. We are showing this is not our country in white color. Okay, so it's from starting from Jammu Kashmir to till this northeast states. Okay, the next one, Indo-Gangetic Brahmaputra Plains. We may call this northern plains. Okay, it's starting from the north western side. It goes till this side. In the middle, we have one country, that is Bangladesh. This is also our neighboring country. So we cannot put any green color here. Okay, but the plain is continuous. Okay, so it's a very fertile place in the world. We say this is the greatest delta in the world. Okay, this place, can you see? All rivers are coming and flowing inside the Bay of Bengal. Very fertile place. Very beautiful place. All plants will grow here. Okay. This is the Indo-Gangetic Brahmaputra Plains. We call one more name by Northern Plains. Next, desert. See, this is the desert. Near Pakistan and in India also. Okay, near Indus Valley. Indus River. Okay, this is the place, yellow in color. Whatever color they mention, you have to mention the same color. Should not use your own colors here. Okay, this is a desert color, is yellow. Okay, it's purely in Rajasthan. Okay, next we'll come peninsular region. Okay, that means this is the yellow, light yellow color. We call this Deccan Plateau. One more name, Deccan Plateau. So far you learnt in one by name, Deccan Plateau is a new name they are giving, peninsular region. Okay, so this is all Deccan Plateau. That is plateau, you know already, a suddenly raised like mountain, on the top will be flat. Okay, table land, that is we call plateaus. So this all yellow, we have plateaus. When we learn about plateaus, we learn more. Okay, next we have Eastern Western Ghats. Both the side, this is Western Ghats, this is Eastern Ghats. East side, Eastern Ghats. West side, Western Ghats. Okay, both dark mountains. These are dark mountains, Ghats. Next one, Coastal Plains. Near the sea, ocean, we have some plain. In Chennai, we are living in a coastal plain. This is our Chennai. We are living in coastal plain. Okay, this all green color we call coastal plain. Okay, it's not just a joke. You have to memorize this up to which state it's going. Immediately, you have to compare with one state map. Up to which state is coming, which state is how many states are inside the northern plains, that is Gangetic plain, how many states are inside the Deccan Plateau, okay, everything you must know in this map, okay. So this also one more map. So far you learnt 3 maps, you are going to do 3 maps. Next, very very interesting map, next one is mountains. Every mountain you are going to name, okay, the mountains you are going to name, okay, these are the names of the mountains we are going to locate in the map, okay. Children, you must know the names and the places of the mountains, you must know, okay, keep that in your mind. You are going to sit and practice at home. Himalayas, okay, can you see Himalayas? It's Himalayas, Himalayas. It starts from there, from Jammu Kashmir, it goes like a range they put. Can you see the middle dot? Yes, this all we call Himalayas, okay. Next one we see Karakoram, yes, in Jammu Kashmir. This long one we call Karakoram mountain, Karakoram range, okay. Third one is Aravalli. This is the Aravalli mountain, that is also range, okay. Next we have Vindhyas. This is Vindhya range, okay. Next Kaimur range, Satpura under the Vindhya range. Next we have Western Ghats, next Eastern Ghats, next one Nilgiri hills. Extends still down. We have Ooty, no? We can Blue Mountain. We call it in English. It's in that place, Ooty. Okay, Nilgiris. Chota Nagpur Plateau. Okay. Now, so far you learnt dark brown is used for mountain ranges and mountains. Now we'll come to Plateau. Chota Nagpur Plateau. In peninsular region till here we saw light yellow color, no? All plateaus I told you that they have name. The biggest one Deccan Plateau, the next one Chota Nagpur Plateau and Malwa Plateau. So this all places are like plateaus only, that's why they call peninsular region, okay. Next one Deccan Plateau, Malwa Plateau, K2 Mount Godwin Austin. This is a mountain peak. See, can you see in Karakoram range we have one triangle, can you see? That is K2 Mount Godwin Austin. Next Kanchenjunga and Thar Desert. This is Kanchenjunga peak, okay, world second highest peak. Which is the first world highest peak? Yes, Everest, Mount Everest. It's in Nepal, okay. Yes, this is Kanchenjunga. Next Thar Desert, we studied desert, no? They are naming this Thar Desert in India, okay. So this also you have to memorize this names and the locations. Interestingly do, if you don't have interest also, you try to know about India. If you are Indian, you will do this, isn't it? Keep that in your mind and learn, and it will be easy for you to learn. Okay, this is fourth map. Next we have two passes. Passes, they are using this kind of brackets like red. Okay. Many of you have books. You borrowed books from other class children. Okay, soon we are also going to give. Don't worry. We'll do. Okay, if you don't have books, don't get scared or anything. We are going to do slowly. This week or next week, we get the books. Okay, see, this is the Karakoram Pass. Okay. Yes. Yes. Next one was Nadula Pass. Okay, on the boundary of territory controlled of India, Jammu and Kashmir region and China. This is the place we call Karakoram Passes. Okay, the next one is we have Nadula Passes. Can you see? Yes, this is the symbol for passes. Okay, on China-India border, lying in the border of China's Tibet and north of Sikkim in India, Nadula passes about 24 km away from Gangtok in the west. Okay, this is the pass. A gap between the two countries. Okay, yes. Next we are going to see Gangetic Plains and Coastal Plains. We studied Gangetic Plain as a physical feature, isn't it? See, this is the Indo-Gangetic Plain. From north to eastern side. I told you this is Bangladesh. It continues in your physical features map, but to elaborately showing, this is the extent. Okay, how many rivers it's crossing. So next one is Coastal Plain. Konkan Coast, Malabar Coast, Coromandel Coast, Northern Circars and Kanara. These are the things. Okay, we both the coastal plains. I told you we are living in coastal plain in Chennai. Okay, this western side we have Konkan Coast, Kanara Coast, Malabar Coast. Malabar Coast in Kerala. Kanara, Karnataka. This Konkan is Goa. Okay, these are the coast. And this side we call Goa, Maharashtra, we call this, it extends. Okay, this side we call here to here Coromandel Coast. Okay, then Northern Circars. This place, all coast have names. Okay, so till from here to there. So you must to mark this in your map. Use like this one for everything, one map. Then you practice. Then you can put it in one map and see. Okay? When you know everything on your own, you can keep it in one map. Until you practice in different maps. Okay? Next we have some gulfs. Okay? Gulf of Kutch, Gulf of Kambat, Gulf of Mannar, Park Strait, Andaman Sea, Chilka Lake, Ulur Lake. Okay, these are the water bodies of India. Okay, can you see? Gulf of Kutch. It's above the Gujarat, that side. Yes. Can you see? Yes, next under the Gujarat, Gulf of Kambat. Okay, water goes inside the land. That we extend inside the land, we call that gulf. Okay, bay is bigger than that. Okay, next to Gulf of Mannar. Can you see Gulf of Mannar? This is Palk Strait to Sri Lanka to India. This pass. Yes, a water body. Next we have Andaman Sea. This Andaman Nicobar Island near whatever the water body we see, that is we call Andaman Sea, Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea, Indian Ocean, that all you know in small class. Yes, this is your Chilka Lake. Can you see Chilka Lake? Yes. And this is your Ulur Lake in Jammu Kashmir. Yes, this water body maps also you are going to do. Okay, around the not inside we have many rivers, that is a different map, rivers map, that also we are going to see. This all Gulf and lakes. Okay, next we have river map. These are the rivers you are going to mark: Indus, Ravi, Bias, Chenab, Jhelum, Satluj, Ganga, Yamuna, Ghagra, Gomti, Gandak, Kosi, Chambal, Betwa, Son, Damodar, Brahmaputra. This all in north only. Narmada, Tapti, Mahanadi. From here only some rivers flowing in south side: Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri, Tungabhadra. Okay. River Indus. It's in Pakistan only, but it goes till Jammu Kashmir. So we are telling that is Indian river. Okay, see, before British separated us, we were together only. So that is Indus River. Can you see Indus River? It goes till here. Yes. Next one, Ravi, Bias, Chenab, Jhelum. Everything near only. River Satluj, River Bias, River Satluj, River Ravi, River Chenab, River Jhelum, these five rivers. Okay, let's say this place is very fertile place. Next one, Ganga, Yamuna. It's very great river in India. Okay, this is Ganga, River Ganga, River Yamuna. Okay, this is river Brahmaputra. We call in India Brahmaputra. In Tibet we call this Tsangpo, the river name. Okay, this river flows and even to Bangladesh. Okay, next one, river Ghagra, river Gomti, Gandak. River Ghagra, River Gomti, River Gandak, River Kosi, River Chambal, River Betwa, River Son. This is Son River. Okay, Ganga, Yamuna, Ghagra, Gomti. You have to take the map and locate the map and write and see, and without looking any map you practice. Okay, and correct it on your own. Gandak, Kosi, Son, Chambal, Betwa. Okay, next Damodar. River Damodar, Brahmaputra, River Brahmaputra, River Narmada, River Tapti, River Mahanadi, River Godavari, River Krishna, River Tungabhadra. Only one river in near south side, Kaveri. Okay. Yes, there are 24 rivers. You have to make a separate map for this and mark and keep. Okay. Okay, can you see the division of states? You must know in which state which river is flowing. That's why they're keeping in the map of states. Okay, so you must learn the states. Very, very important. Okay, learn according to the direction. North side, how many states are there? What are the states? In south side, western side, eastern side. This is northeast. Especially, you have to memorize this. You learnt in your 8th standard. Okay, so you must know the states. Then only you are able to locate the rivers in that correct state. Okay. See, for example, now you have taken Ganga and Yamuna. Ganga and Yamuna. This is the state, Uttar Pradesh. Ganga and Yamuna. Okay, here Mahanadi and Tapti. This is the place where Indus flows still there. So like that you are able to, this is the place where Brahmaputra flows. Okay, next we'll have monsoon. Southwest monsoon from Arabia, Arabian Sea. Southwest monsoon from Bay of Bengal. This is Arabian Sea, this is Bay of Bengal. From here the winds flows and we get rain. Dead. This is Arabian branch, southwest monsoon. You have to keep this arrows this side and flows from this water bodies. The rain starts and goes to this land. Okay, this is in the month of June to September. India gets the rainfall from this branch, Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal's branch. We call that rain name southwest monsoon. Okay, in Tamil we call Tenmerku Paruvamalai. Okay, yes. Next we'll have northeast monsoon. Okay, that is in December to February. Northeast monsoon. Okay, from northeast to the rains comes this way. Okay, northeast monsoons. Okay, one more thing we have to learn, western disturbance. From Central Asia we are getting rain. In this places we are getting rain from Central Asia. Okay, that we call western disturbance. Okay, see this one. The western disturbance or westerly depressions bring moderate rainfall in Punjab, Haryana, Uttarakhand and western Uttar Pradesh, and snowfall in Jammu and Kashmir and Himachal Pradesh. Yes, these are the states we are getting rainfall and snowfall from western side, western disturbance. Okay, so till that you have to learn map. Okay, northeast monsoon, southwest monsoon, rivers, water bodies, plains, passes. You can mention this passes in the mountains itself. Okay, passes in red in color. You can mention this here in red. No need to have separate map. Okay, put this passes map inside the mountain map. This is your physical features map. This same color you have to use. Do with interest. This is your standard meridian map. Meridian means longitude. Okay, and this 23 degree north latitude and 82 degree and a half standard longitude. standard meridian, one more name longitude. Okay, sometimes we call longitude. Okay, this is the extension of India, 8 degree to 37 degree, 68 and half degree to 97 and half a degree. Okay, do this maps, and next week I will give you assignment through Google Classroom. Send all your maps in that. Okay, thank you children, God bless you. Watch again, then you will understand. Wait for the book, you will get. Don't get scared of anything, and you may take to submit the maps when your books comes. Okay, those who have book, you do your map. I know many of you borrowed a book from your before class children. Yes, some of you don't have, so you get the book and do the map. Okay, thank you children, God bless you.